Hey guys, how's it going? Or how the fuck is going? This is a continuation of that video. I might just cut this shit and not just even show it, but the video was getting really long for that whole video collection thing. So this is part two, or not, I'm just gonna cut it and just keep going. This is Chimera? Yeah, Chimera. Sorry. With the dehumanizing process. Chimera, really good band. Their vocals and never really cared for it, but they were a good band for that time, and I wish they could have changed it up a little bit. At least the vocals could have gotten a little bit harsher or deeper or changed it up. Yeah. Cradle of Filth with heavy left-handed. Okay. Anyway, good stuff. Really good live show of Cradle of Filth back in the day. Now I don't even know what they sound like. I heard their new last two albums were okay, but yeah. After I lost that dude with the I don't know, some sort of dreadlocks. Yeah, I lost touch. Children of Bodom with Chaos Written Years, Stockholm Knockout Live. If you like Children of Bodom or that Swedish metal type sound or folky sound, they put a lot of that into it. Children of Bodom was always really good. I think they're still playing, not really sure, lost touch. They became super popular afterwards. That's when I think I stopped listening to most of their stuff, because didn't sound like they used to. Here's your bottom. Arch Enemy, Live Apocalypse. I believe this one they still had their vocalist. I forgot her name, but yeah, really cool stuff. That's their second vocals before the other girl that came in. Judas Priest with British Steel. Good stuff. Total band that I really love and was before its time to me, at least. This is the principles and practices of the Berserker. Again, way before its time. Very experimental in that grindcore scene. Really cool stuff. They do a brutal cover of Carcass. Again, if you haven't don't know what the Berserker is or was, check him out. He actually does, when they recorded this DVD, they actually show the whole production length entirely of recording their album, their debut album, and the trials and tribulations that fans go through. That dude went through a lot of shit just to make his dream come true. He did, but afterwards he stopped doing it. Just out of the whole process that went into it, drained a lot of out of him, and yeah, Berserker, brutal stuff. Eric Records, I believe, or I think it was Eric Records. Yeah, Eric. Lacuna Coil. Well, Lacuna Coil was really nice. I like their sound. Visual Karma. This is when Karma Code came out. 6 Feet Under with A Decade Under the Grave. In the Grave, sorry. This comes with a 5 discs. Jesus Christ. Oh, it's 2 CDs, 3 CDs. And 1 DVD. Comes with some little cards here from the band. The Cannibal himself. Yeah, comes with a nice little booklet here. Pictures and the notes and stuff like that. Cool stuff. What else is here?
pretty big.
Comes with a big sticker that I never use. I just keep it in there. Crisp. Comes with a giant poster on the ceiling of just of the same cover. I'm not gonna bust that out. Same cover. You can tell it's the same cover. What else is in here? Besides that, it's just the CDs and DVDs that come in it. That's pretty cool box set, I guess. Damn, it comes with a shit ton of CDs, DVDs, unreleased shit or something. Can't really remember what's in this. It's been a while since I watched this. It'll be a long time since I before I watch this again, I guess. Moving on. Still got a lot. Nothing Lasts Forever. Death metal. Are we watching you die? Cringiest title ever. This is the state of, I guess, death metal during this time, and obviously, you know, it's still going strong. Ultimate Revenge. This is another little compilation from that Metal Minds Productions type thing. Obviously, I'm a big Polish metal fan, or death metal fan. Various artists, a guide to Polish death metal. The death black metal scene. You guys could kind of read that. It has really cool bands in here. Vader, Dite Disease, Decapitated, Septic, Trauma. Really cool, underrated band. Behemoth, Belphegor, Dire, Zyra. I think I said Vader already. Moon, The Yattering, Agony Christ. Agony Christ. Witchmaster. Cool stuff. Horoscope, Hellborn, Born, Hate, Anal Stench, Machine Head, Eagles. I don't know. I loved early Machine Head stuff. This one was Killswitch Engage. Good stuff for its time. Oh, here it is. This is the little booklet that I mentioned before. Before the Light Takes Us. Cool black metal documentary about the deaths in black metal in Norway. Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon. Love Pink Floyd. Punishment in Capitals, Napalm Death. Killer fucking shit. I have that shit on fucking CD as well. Awesome album. I hardly listen to live albums, but that's one of them that I could just listen to live because it's just that fucking good. Despise Icon, Quebec band, really good stuff. This is one band that I think they came back and they're playing now. Of course, I got Sepultura because fucking Latino. Yeah. Type of Negative, Symphony for the Devil. Alright, on to the last pile. Well, two last piles. Devourment with official DVD. Yeah, sick stuff. Obviously, if you're into brutal death metal, slash slam, you should know who the fuck this is. Really disgusting stuff that happens in here. Got two fans, one laying down shirtless while the other one purposely vomits on top of him. Yeah. Debarment. Another band, Total Fucking Worship, Deeds of Fucking Flesh. Killer shit, Unique Live Records, live in Montreal. Yeah, only released one DVD. I would hope that they would release their Bloodletting North America tours, if there is videos for that. I'd love to see that shit. Deeds of Flesh. awesome. Carnal Forge with Destroy Live. Really cool thrash band, or Swedish thrash, or new wave Swedish thrash, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Cool band, check them out. Really cool shit. If you like the Haunted, or get your toes with in At the Gates, the Haunted, you need to listen to Carnal Forge. Slayer, still raining. Yeah, I fell out of love with Slayer. Sorry, a while ago. The last album that I heard from Slayer was Diabolus in Musica. I know a lot of people hate that album, and I know you're saying, "Oh, that's why you stopped listening to him." Because no, it's just everything sounds the same, and I just can't stand the way he just fucking screams all the time. Before he went to screaming and semi-singing to now just fucking screaming and using that fucking megaphone or whatever the fuck that shit is called. Yeah, I can't stand that shit. But love me some fucking Slayer. Don't get me fucking wrong. Don't think I hate Slayer. I love Slayer, but don't know what they sound like now, nor do I care, nor do I want to find out what they sound like now. I lost touch. Jeff Hanneman obviously died, and rest in peace, was one of the best guitarists in metal. And Kerry King, if he would shut the fuck up, that would be one thing that would get me back to listening to Slayer. But it just, no. Or let Gary Holt do some stuff in Slayer or something. Yeah. 6 Feet Under, didn't even know I had this. Wake the Night, live in Germany. Okay. Cannibal Corpse, this is Centuries of Torment. I believe this comes up, yeah. Comes with a nice metal. This is when, I guess you can see Black Dahlia Murder Nocturnal is about to drop. Cool stuff. Yeah, this is the history of Cannibal Corpse and obviously live stuff. And what I'm looking at, I think I'm missing a CD or a DVD. Fucking hell. Autopsy. Fuck yes. Born Undead. Fucking Autopsy. Really cool shit, man. If you don't know Autopsy, I don't know what the fuck you're doing with your life. But yeah. Autopsy, man. Well. Another Behemoth, when they're, I guess they're super popular at this point now. With, is this Evangelic Heretica something? Cool stuff. Still like Behemoth. Decapitated. Steelbook. Or case. Hope everything turns out for well for Decapitated. Yeah, fucking love Decapitated. Lamb of God, Walk With Me in Hell. Now this, I think in this video, because they showed, I think the making of Sacrament. Yeah. It's in this thing, I think, where, to me at least, it started going down fucking hill. At least for me, for Lamb of God. I think in there, their producer started telling them that, why don't you try singing a little bit, and yeah. Cyclone. Killer shit. Was supposed to be a super band that was supposed to come out. I believe the drummer was from Emperor. It had a couple of cool guys in it, but I think Behemoth came and just fucking smashed through what this band was supposed to be. You know how bands, sometimes there's a lot of hype into them. Really cool band nonetheless. Fucking love me some fucking Cyclone, but I think Behemoth kind of fucking derailed their advancement. But really cool band. Black metal music of Satan. Now, finally, an honest documentary about this stuff. Okay, if you say so. Bills Above Productions. I remember this, yeah. This is actually some really, really, really good, really good stuff. There's good interviews in this. Has some really good bands in this. The Rotting Christ, Amy Border, Cradle Filth, Behemoth, Belphegor, Satyricon, Primordial, Fintrol, Necrophar, Creator, Celtic Frost, Blood Throne, Dark Funeral, Gorgoroth, Enslaved, obviously, Apsu, Marduk, Mayhem, Immortal. I think I said Enslaved, but yeah. Lamb of God, this is really good shit. This is from Killadelphia. Yeah. This is a really good DVD. This is the one to see. This is where Randy gets his ass fucking handed to him by his fucking guitarist, man. That's what happens when you start drinking too much and act like a fucking dick and don't know how to handle your liquor. But yeah. Lamb of God. This one. Funny story about this one. As when they toured with Cannibal Corpse and Demon Border and The Haunted, Lamb of God was opening up for all of them. They were the first band, I forgot what they called it. When they played the first show in New Jersey, I saw their first show in Jersey, I went over there, and then their last show was at the Lamplight in New York. And when I went to Jersey, funny thing about this tour, and it shows up here anyway, Randy the vocalist, they had a little bus that their van that they were traveling in, he got totally wasted, that he shat himself in the van, and it shows him waking up discovering that he actually shit himself and running into the woods, which is kind of fucking hilarious. Next you got KMFDM, which tour 2003. I love KMFDM. That's one of those stages. That's when metal during that time was like so fucking. It had so many branches and roots all over the place that you kind of had to dig for certain bands. KMFDM was always a really good band, very popular, and at the same time, a lot of people didn't know about KMFDM, but I really dig their sound. It has Drug Against War, one of my favorite songs. I could just hear that right now, and it gets me kind of pumped up a little bit. KMFDM, cool shit. Rammstein, this is all their good tracks, and obviously their videos, most of their videos during that time. Paul Booth, Last Rites. I got this because this is total worship of the artwork that this man has ever done. Kind of reminds me of this a little bit with his Leaf Man. He does the awesome tattoos all over the place. He actually shows up that he's tattooing the dude from Lamb of God in this. Cool stuff. Hate Eternal. Fucking awesome shit. Fucking love me some fucking Hate Eternal, man. Death Metal Documentary. This one's really good. Really, really good. Really cool stuff. Yeah. What's this? That One Night. This is live in Buenos Aires. Megadeth. This is really cool. That's when they start chanting Megadeth. Fucking Megadeth, I believe, in the crowd. Really cool shit. Symphony Destruction. Cool stuff. Another Metal Dark Side 2 with Jasmine St. Clair. Cool stuff. Cool interviews. Interview with Frank Mueller. Suffocation in this. Really cool stuff. Got Megadeth Video Hits. Cool stuff. Another Megadeth. Arsenal of Megadeth. This is all their music videos, 20-minute unreleased live footage. cool stuff. We got some fucking Marduk. Cool shit. Now, this next one.
Cataclysm?
I had this when, 2007, when it first came out, I had this. I got this in the Metalhead box, I forgot one month, but I got this twice, because I have two subscriptions to the Metalhead box, regular, and then I changed to vinyl, but this is going to be the two extra ones that I have of this. I'm keeping the original, because this is the one that I've watched the shit out of. I like Cataclysm. Obviously, their older stuff is obviously more brutal and awesome. A lot of people would agree with me on that, but I like Cataclysm. For that, this time that they were around they were making this kind of music, it was good, appropriate for that time. So anyway, in my Facebook page, the other video that I make, I'll make it clear what my Facebook page is and stuff, because I'm still working on that shit because I'm fucking lazy. I'll be giving two of these copies away if you like on Cataclysm. Really good stuff. Good, well recorded. Good shit. Okay, we got some Chrisium. Really cool stuff. Obviously, fucking this trio. Amazing blasting beats that these guys make. So fucking fast and furious. Shit. Fast and furious. Cool shit. Now we got a series that I just got all together. Oh wait, I still got two more here. This is a metal, a Headbanger's Journey. This is actually pretty good. It has good interviews, very well recorded because obviously fucking money. But a lot of dedication put into this stuff, on this documentary. Really good stuff. Don't agree with much, most of the stuff that the dude talks about and metal nowadays, but he knows his older stuff. He's on point with all that shit. One of my favorite bands ever. This is fucking Macabre, live in Holland. Say anything bad about Macabre, we're going to blows, man. I'm gonna fucking fight you. But, yeah, I love Macabre. This is another band that obviously doesn't take their stuff too seriously, even though the themes that they're talking about are very serious. But this comes in an awesome fucking tin box with a cool little mesh thing hiding the DVD. Really well protected. Yeah, Macabre. Obviously, Murder, Worship. All their lyrics and songs and albums are dedicated to murderers. Awesome stuff. Love that shit. Now you got a little compilation, a little series that came out from Metal Blade Records. Oh no, Nuclear Blast, I'm sorry. Nuclear Blast. And that's my cat dying back. On that note, I'll just pop open another cerveza. He's still asleep. He's not gonna wake up. Anyway, moving on to Nuclear Blast. Again, forgive for the for my mistake. Nuclear Blast released a couple of series of DVDs. I stopped collecting them because I had nowhere to get them afterwards. FYE closed down, and I wasn't about to. I didn't like ordering shit online. Now it's the only way. But they released Monsters of Metal. There's no in particular order. This is number 6. Has Dimmu Borgir, Legion of the Damned, Exodus, Obituary, Creator, Death Angel, Soilwork, Gojira, Nihil, Rage, Divinity, Requiem, Epica, Scar Cemetery, really cool band, Meshuggah, Keep of Kellison, Saxon, bunch of other bands. Obviously, that you'll probably see in Donington or something like that. Another one here. This is Volume 4. Again, some of these bands that show up, some of these videos are the same from the last one. You got Elegy, Iced Earth, Master Plan, Primal Fear, Annihilator, Communic. MOD, Strapping Young Lad, Suffocation, Napalm Death, Drew Sentence, which is a really good band. This was the first one, I believe. Monsters of Metal, the Ultimate Metal Compilation Double. This is the first one. And it had bands like Hammerfall, Halloween, Destruction, Farmer Boys, Stratovarius, Sona Arctica, Morbid Angel, Paradise Lost, Iron Maiden, Seven Dust, bands like that. Really good stuff. Volume 5, Monsters of Metal. Scar Cemetery, Catatonia, Death Stars, Lacuna Coil, same stuff. Cataract, Tankard, Sentence, Neglafar. And there was a couple of bands, different ones here and there, but they were mostly were the same. Different videos sometimes you got the same ones, but yeah. Monsters of Metal Volume 2. Again, you got some differences like Samael, Arch Enemy, Hypocrisy, Bolt Thrower, Graveworm, Darkane, Dark Tranquility, Rhapsody, Tiamat, Fireball Ministry, Therion, Nevermore, Ectomorph, which is the I think they're from Stone. But anyway, they were the answer to Sepultura back in the day. Still making music. Down to the last couple of them, and I'm overjoyed because this is taking forever. I'm starting to kind of lose my voice a little. Ozzy Osbourne. Don't Blame Me, The Tales of Ozzy Osbourne. Pretty much a documentary of the epic life of this dude during that time. This is another one, Intense Metal Drumming. Never learned dick from, but really cool stuff from George Kolias, drummer from Nihil and his own project. And I think he does a lot of side projects too. It's starting to pile up. hold on, let me just move this aside here, put this here, there we go. Bloodbath. This is Bloodbath over Bloodstock. Really cool shit, when they show up all bloody and shit. Really cool stuff. We have Slayer. Cool stuff. This one, I really like this one. This one was really good. This is when they released, obviously. I think this is when that dude went to that show and carved Slayer in his forearm and set it up blaze or something. And in that Divine Intervention CD, if you looked at the CD, that's the dude's arms were out, carved Slayer in it. Cool. This is Cannibal Corpse, Global Evisceration. Cool stuff. Another thing I didn't know I had this is from 2010. Pantera, Vulgar Videos from Hell. Another really old one. You can tell by the type of DVD casing, which I always despised because they're so hard to take care of, but this is in fairly good shape, minus the dust on it. Lamentations from Opeth, I love this fucking DVD. I actually have this on Blu-ray because I think it did come out on Blu-ray. Fucking awesome. I believe it's on Blu-ray. Vader and the blood was shed in Warsaw. Fucking cool ass artwork. I don't know why they didn't put that on a CD or something. This came in a really weird package, packaging. Got the here, which had the little booklet. And then this part here, you had to actually, a little tab here that you had to pull out like so. And yeah, that was kind of cool. Pain in the ass to take care of, but yeah, it was pretty cool. Down to my last four or five. Nail Bomb. Fucking killer shit. Live at Dynamo. Yeah. Dynamo. Yes. It's late. Sorry. Nail Bomb. Fuck yes. Total fucking worship, man. I love me some fucking Nail Bomb. Hell yeah, man. Nail Bomb is the shit. I heard that they're doing Cavalera Conspiracy are starting. They're gonna play some Nail Bomb songs, which is really cool to hear. Or they did already, I'm not sure. Mashuga. Gotta have you some fucking Mashuga. Yeah. Nothing else to say but fucking Mashuga. Now, in that little vein, oh wait, you got Hypocrisy. Fuck yes. This is live and clips. Really cool shit. Classic lineup there. Fucking Lars. Awesome shit. Yeah, man. Fucking Hypocrisy. Now, the last ones that I'm gonna. One is part of that Nuclear Blast Monsters of Metal type series. But they released two. I don't know if there was any more of that because I never heard anything else from that. This is Monsters of Death. This was really, really cool. I was very into this. Obviously, it had bands like Sentence, Dismember, Dissection was in there. Both were Darkane Unleashed, Gorefest, Plunge and Stench, Impaled Nazarene, in the Entombed, Sinister Mortification, fucking had Dying Fetus, Monstrosity, Morgoth, Brutal Truth, Decapitated, Cannibal Corpse, Cyclone, Misery Index, Winter Song. Really cool stuff. Came in two discs. Fucking turn. Yes, pretty old. We got the second one, I believe. This is part two. Yeah, the Ultimate Death Metal Compilation, Volume 2. Monsters of Death from Nuclear Blast. Again, you have bands like Death at the Gates, Cannibal Corpse, Obituary, Carcass, Unleashed, Immolation, or Morbid Angel, DSI, Legion of Damned, Dismember, Benediction, Christian, Death Beneath, Severe Torture, Impious, or Impious, or whatever you want to call it, Merciless, Belphegor, Disbelief, Morgoth, Two Senses, The Crown. Cool shit. And the last one, finally, is Get Thrash. The Story of Thrash Metal. Now this one fucking is one of the best, or if not the best, thrash metal documentary ever put out. Period. The reason why is it comes in two discs. I believe it comes in two discs and still semi-sealed there because I haven't opened it, because an interesting thing about this, I had this a long time ago and I gave my copy away to some dude that came to work for me, and he was a metalhead, and we talked about thrash and stuff, and I told him, hey, listen, he used to like the old school stuff as like I did, and he remembers all those bands but wasn't in touch with the newer stuff or the new wave thrash metal that it was starting to come out, like Toxic Holocaust and all that other shit. But we had an excellent conversation. he was out of touch of a scene, obviously. But I gave him this, my copy, only copy that I had. Because so he could just, because I was telling him so much good stuff about this. Obviously, he wasn't in the scene anymore, so he didn't know what the hell I was talking about. But I told him, here's a documentary that I have that talks about not only the big fucking four, because honestly, fuck those guys. Talking about the big five or six, in my eyes, that should have been there. Fucking Overkill, Testament, Exodus, and this other band that I'm totally forgetting about now, but definitely should have fucking been there in the big fucking 5, 6, 8. Should have never been the big four, because some of those bands are not even playing thrash metal anymore. And, period. But yeah, this band, this documentary not only shows, obviously what you're gonna see here, you're gonna see Slayer, fucking Dave Mustaine, and fucking Scott Ian. And they're gonna focus a lot of thrash metal in the early beginnings of thrash. And not only that, but they touch a lot of and have really good interviews with Hyrax, Death Angel, all those other sometimes obscure bands that you probably didn't heard of, or that I can't even fucking start to tell you guys right now, because this is really that good. On the other side, they do a big interview with Testament and all those other Bay Area bands and fucking San Francisco, bands from San Francisco, all over the place. Really, really good, highly recommended thrash metal documentary. The only thrash metal documentary, period. And with that, having said that, this is probably going to be the only link that I'm going to do, because I'm not going to do that or drop a link to all that other shit that I just showed you guys, because this is the one that you should probably take a look at. If you want to check out the rest of them, fine, but this one is really, really fucking good. And with that being said, yeah, thanks for watching and putting up with 37 minutes of video. The other one's probably the same length, 37 minutes part one. But yeah, I'm almost out of voice, and like I always end these things, take care of yourselves, take care of each other. Cheers. I'm out.